Conventional methods of measuring toxic elements in the human body have significant limitations. For example, information from urine, blood, and serum can account only for recent exposure. Bone biopsies, meanwhile, are invasive, can be conducted only once, and they're painful and carry risks for patients. At the forefront of elemental analysis research in humans and biological samples, Professor Ana Pejović-Milić is developing diagnostic techniques for in vivo and ex vivo analysis.
My research interest is in developing diagnostic tools to measure accumulation of toxic and trace elements in human tissues. More specifically, we develop methods to measure accumulation of these elements in human calcified tissues, such as bone, skeleton, or teeth. To do that, we use applied nuclear physics methods, such as X-ray fluorescence and neutron activation analysis. What we do, we measure strontium accumulated in the finger bone, specifically here at this bone, and we can repeat that, and presently we do repeat that either weekly or monthly, depends on the availability of subjects. This gives us information of the change of strontium over time in the patient's daily supplementing or being treated with strontium-based medication to treat osteoporosis. So it's a diagnostic tool to basically help out judge how effective certain treatment for osteoporosis is. What we see is that over time, strontium bone levels are constantly increasing, and this study is still in progress. The guiding principles of diagnostic tools that we develop is that they are non-invasive, therefore they are painless, and they allow us to monitor accumulation of different toxic and trace elements over time in the same subject.